The Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. I ask, now we'll have an invocation by His Eminence Archbishop Epiphoros of America of the Greek Orthodox Archdiocese.
May we bow our heads in prayer. In the name of God, who asks only that who do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly in the divine presence, amen. We give you thanks and praise, O God, for gathering us together today to invoke your blessing and mercy upon this noble Senate of New York State. We humbly ask for your beneficence upon every member of this Senate, who earnestly pursues the welfare of all citizens of the great state of New York. We give you thanks and praise for the recognition of the Greek War of Independence in the Declaration of March 2023 as Greek History Month. We ask your special grace and wisdom upon the Senate as you blessed the wise King Solomon. We beseech that you inspire their vigilance for the people of the great state of New York, as you inspired the judge of Israel, Deborah. And we ask that you grant them the strength of the judge Samson, that they may persevere in justice and righteousness all the days of their service to the people. Bless these lawgivers, that they may ever render wholesome and right judgments for all citizenry, and thus render glory, reverence, and honor to you who are the source and foundation of the law. Amen.
Reading of the journal. In Senate, Tuesday, March 21st, 2023, Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Monday, March 20th, 2023 was read and approved. On motion, Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees. Communications and reports from state offices. Motions and resolutions. Senator Gennaris.
Thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of Senator Stavisky, I wish to call up Senate Print 1043, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 153, Senate Print 1043 by Senator Stavisky, an act to amend the education law.
Move to reconsider the vote by which the bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Orsul, Cousins-White, ayes 52.
The bill is restored to its place in the third reading calendar.
I offer the following amendments.
The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place in the third reading calendar.
Mr. President, can we now move to previously adopted Resolution 580 by the distinguished Senator Giannaris? Read its title only and recognize me, please.
Please take up a previously adopted Resolution 580 by the incredibly distinguished Senator Giannaris. Read the resolution title only and recognize Senator Giannaris in the resolution. Secretary, read.
Senate Resolution 580 by Senator Giannaris, memorializing Governor Kathy Hochul to proclaim March 2023 as Greek History Month in the state of New York in conjunction with the commemoration of the 202nd anniversary of Greek independence.
Senator Giannaris.
Thank you, Mr. President. We just heard the invocation from the leader of the Greek Orthodox Church in the Americas, His Eminence Archbishop Epiphoros, and that is an honor for those of us who are members of the church and are of Hellenic descent. And this body includes myself and Senator Grenardis and Senator Skoufis, as well as two members of the Assembly who collectively organized a luncheon earlier today where we heard His Eminence give remarks. We were also honored to be joined by the Consul Generals of Greece, Konstantinos Konstantinou, who is here with us in the chamber, and of Cyprus, Michalis Fidilas, who was also with us today. This was a tradition that existed many years ago, and then the pandemic and other factors slowed it down. So I want to credit Senator Grunardis and his team for doing a lot of the work and reestablishing a day here at the Capitol where we honor our heritage and remind everyone of the contributions of the Greek people to democracy and to the life and freedoms we have here in the United States. And this is a resolution we pass every year here in this chamber. I'm honored to be a child of immigrants from Greece. It's a little bit of a joke, certainly in the movies, that the Greeks take credit for everything, but we do that because it's true. And whether it's democracy or science or mathematics or medicine, you could take your pick, but the ancients had a lot to do with where we are today, and it's something those of us who have that DNA, including Senator Scarsella Spanton, who's not here, she has some of it, are incredibly proud of and work very hard to live up to those ideals and those freedoms. So I want to thank my colleagues for giving us the opportunity to spend a few minutes in session today talking about this and the importance of our history and our heritage to New York. I want to thank His Eminence for joining us. He's been here since last night. Many of us shared dinner with him last night, and I know he visited already today with the governor and the leaders of the houses and many of us over in the LOB at the luncheon. So thank you to all who were involved in this. Thank you for supporting the Greek community here in New York, and thank you, Mr. President, for giving me a few minutes to discuss it.
Thank you, Senator Gennaris. Senator Skoufis on the resolution.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. First, I want to thank Senator Gennaris, Deputy Leader Gennaris, for introducing the resolution, as well as my fellow Greek-American legislator, Senator Grunardis, who plays an instrumental role in organizing the events today and even last night, and general partnership among our small but mighty Greek-American caucus here in the State Senate. And I assure all my colleagues who are probably concerned about the remarks and the length of the remarks that you're going to hear from all of us Greek Americans today, that cumulatively, we will probably be a tenth of the time that Tim Kennedy was yesterday on Irish Heritage Month and its resolution. I'd also like to particularly thank the Archbishop for today's invocation, for being here with us as we prepare to celebrate Greek Independence Day and recognize the contributions, many of which Senator Gennaris outlined, from our Greek and Greek-American brothers and sisters. It really is an honor to be in His Eminence's presence, and we're all grateful for his leadership, spiritual and otherwise. I, too, am extremely proud of my Greek heritage, Mr. President, and of the thousands of Greek Americans who live and work in the state of New York. And I'm delighted to highlight two of these individuals. You know, Senator Grunardis is part of the celebration here in the state legislature. He has started his own tradition in allowing us Greek American legislators to highlight one or a couple of our constituents and honor them as part of these proceedings. And this year, from my district, I have Andy and Popey Chronopoulos, who immigrated to Highland Falls, a community in Orange County back in the 1960s. They brought with them terrific Greek cuisine. They tirelessly ran an amazing restaurant in the community, which really served as a gathering place for over 37 years. And to this day, they remain staples within our tight-knit Orange County community, volunteering with local organizations, passing their legacy of quiet generosity onto their two sons and two grandkids. I'm honored to share their brief stories, part of the annual Greek Independence Day celebration here in the Senate. My family, like so many other immigrant families, came to this country seeking a more promising future for themselves and their next generations. And to that end, there's a traditional Greek proverb that reads, "A society grows great when old men plant trees whose shade they know they shall never sit in." During World War II, when the Nazis occupied Greece, the occupying forces stole the food that was grown in farming communities like the one which my family was from in the mountains of Western Greece, leading to widespread famine. An estimated 300,000 Greeks died of that starvation, including my grandmother's parents. My yaya went on from having two parents to being an orphan in just a matter of weeks during that period. Years later, my grandparents made the difficult decision to take my father and his siblings to the United States. They settled in Brooklyn. My papu's first job, which he enjoyed until retirement, was very proud, it was at the Nathan's Hot Dog Stand in Coney Island. They arrived in America with next to nothing, but over decades worked hard to earn a place in New York's working class. My father went on to open a Greek deli in Bay Ridge, which Senator Gennardis still gets his feta cheese from. In coming to the United States, like so many other Greek Americans, my family planted trees for me and my generation of relatives, some of whose shade, indeed, they themselves will never sit in. This resolution to recognize March as Greek History Month in the state of New York is a celebration of all who have come before us and planted trees in their stead, advancing contributions in democracy and science and theater and philosophy and so many other aspects of our day-to-day lives as Americans. Now, as a father and a state senator representing over 300,000 New Yorkers, I don't lose sight of the fact that it's now my turn to help plant as many trees as I can for those that come after me. I want to leave you all with one last contribution from the Greeks that may be less obvious. The Hippocratic Oath, the guiding principle our medical professionals still subscribe to today. Like the doctors who take this oath, we as legislators have an obligation to do no harm and to work each day to improve the lives of New Yorkers from all backgrounds. Thank you, Mr. President, and to all my colleagues for the moment you've given me, and happy Greek Independence Day to all of us.
Thank you, Senator Skoufis. Senator Gennardis on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. And I want to thank Senator Gennardis and Senator Skoufis for their partnership and support in allowing us to celebrate our heritage and our history today. This year, we're celebrating the 202nd anniversary of Greece's independence after 400 years of subjugation and slavery by the Ottoman Empire. On March 25, 1821, revolutionary fighters gathered together with Metropolitan Germanos in the monastery of Agia Lavra in the village of Kalavrita, which I think is where Senator Gennardis' family's from, and declared the beginning of the revolution against Ottoman oppression. What followed was a seven-year war that ended with the creation of the Hellenic Republic and would lead to the spread of revolutionary fervor across the European continent and would remake the world. As a fourth-generation Greek-American, I am proud of this history. I think about the words of the Greek national anthem, the Hymn to Liberty, by Dionysios Solomos. I shall always recognize you by the dreadful sword you hold, as the earth with searching vision you survey with spirit bold. From the Greeks of old, whose dying brought to life and spirit free, now with ancient valor rising, let us hail you, O Liberty. Every time I hear that anthem, I swell with pride at the poem's conclusion, a resounding ode to the price and cost of national freedom. How fitting to reflect on these words as we see the people of Ukraine fight for the survival of their country and paying for their liberty with their lives. Today, we are joined in the chamber by representatives of both the Hellenic Republic and the Republic of Cyprus, because the history and destiny of the Greek and Cypriot people are shared and linked together. And we thank the Consul General for being with us here today. But it's not just the history of the revolution and Greece's independence that I'm proud to celebrate. It's the contributions of the Greek American community to our nation that are also worthy of praise and celebration. For the past 100 plus years, Greeks have emigrated to the United States in search of peace, stability, and a better life for themselves and their families. They came to escape the persecutions of the Ottoman Empire. They came to be spared the devastations of World War I. They came to be saved from the terrors of the Asia Minor Holocaust and the burning of Smyrna. They came to be spared the horrors of World War II. They came to find peace during the Greek Civil War. They came to seek safety and opportunity during the unrest of the 60s and 70s. For 100 plus years, Greeks have sought out the light of freedom offered by Lady Liberty, and came to the United States in the hopes of a better life. When the United States adopted immigration quotas in 1924, it would only accept 100 Greeks per year to come into this country, and yet still our people came by the hundreds and by the thousands and tens of thousands. And let's not forget just how unwanted Greeks were in this country. Greek immigrants endured decades of harassment, intimidation, discrimination, and violence, all because they looked different than other Americans, spoke a different language from other Americans, and took low-paying jobs away from other Americans. In fact, the Ku Klux Klan viewed Greek immigrants as a threat to the United States. They attacked Greek businesses, burned crosses on Greek lawns, encouraged doctors to sterilize Greek women, and beat, and even in some cases murdered, Greek immigrants. It was not uncommon to see "No Greeks Wanted" signs in store windows, or even to see Greek men flogged for having dared to date a white woman. Greek immigrants were encouraged to prove themselves of being equal to whites by taking undesirable jobs such as building railroads, cleaning sewage, laying pavement, and working in factories. And yet still our people came, enduring injustice after injustice, all in the hopes of living a better life here. They didn't just come for themselves, but for their children and their children's children. They came here so that one day, 100 years later, 75 years later, 50 years later, there could be three Greek Americans elected to serve their communities in a body as august as the New York State Senate. And so as we stand here today celebrating the 202nd anniversary of Greek independence and declare Greek History Month in the state of New York, I am ever hopeful for the future of our community here in America. And this moment represents an opportunity for reflection. At a time when individuals across our country are being subjected to violence, bigotry, and discrimination because they come from different countries, speak different languages, have different customs, eat different foods, it's incumbent upon those of us whose ancestors endured similar treatment to stand up and condemn the ugliness of racism wherever it rears its ugly head. That we remember the struggles of our forefathers and we open our hands and we open our hearts to all those whose stories mirror our own and embrace our fellow human beings as true brothers and sisters. It's with this spirit that I'm particularly proud that today that we're joined as well by His Eminence Archbishop Epilephoros of America, the spiritual leader of the Greek Orthodox Church in the United States. For some of my colleagues who may not know, the Greek Orthodox Church in America has long played an active role in the advancement of civil, political, and human rights in this country. The American Hellenic Educational Progressive Association, better known as AHEPA, was founded in 1922 in Atlanta, Georgia, to counter the bigotry and racism of the KKK. We're also joined here by some of the national leadership from AHEPA in the gallery. It was our own Archbishop Iakovos who joined Dr. King in Selma, attended the funeral of Reverend James Reeb, and marched across the Edmund Pettus Bridge in the fight for equality for Black Americans. And during the protests for racial justice after the murder of George Floyd, it was Archbishop Epilephoros who was out there in the streets, just as many of us were, marching to support the movement for Black lives. So, Mr. President, on today, March 22nd, and with great pride and humility, I thank my colleagues for their indulgence and for their support of this resolution, and I wish all Greeks and Philhellenes everywhere a happy Greek Independence Day. Zito I Ellada. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Gennardis. To our guests, I welcome you on behalf of the Senate. We extend to you the privileges and courtesies of this House. Please rise and be recognized. Senator Serrano.
Thank you, Mr. President. Let's please take our previously adopted resolution 210.
Senator Serrano, I'm sorry, point of order. The resolution was previously adopted on March 21st. Senator Serrano.
Okay. Let's take a previously adopted resolution 210 by Senator Persaud. Read the resolution title only and recognize Senator Persaud on the resolution.
Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 210 by Senator Persaud, memorializing Governor Kathy Hochul to proclaim March 22, 2023 as Doula Day in the state of New York.
Persaud in the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. March 22nd to 28th is time to be grateful for all that doulas provide. Doula Celebration Day initially started on March 22nd, 2011 to mark spring's equinox, also meaning the return of fertility in many different cultures. Doulas are non-clinical personnel who provide healthcare services to pregnant women during, before, and after pregnancy. They provide individualized physical, emotional, and informational support, as well as advocacy to their clients. Doula care is an evidence-based practice that is associated with healthier birth outcomes for both a pregnant person and their newborn infant. And there is a lack of awareness, resources, and training that is important resource that's underserved. A 2013 study found that doulas serve as the pregnant person's advocate for empowering them to make informed decisions for themselves and their child. Continuous support by doulas is linked to significant reduction in childbirth complications and cesarean births. Doula services are also important strategies in addressing the maternal health crisis, which was prioritized in the fiscal year 2023 president's budget. A 2022 issue brief by the Office of Health Policy found that doulas can mitigate racial inequity in maternal health outcomes in communicating their clients' needs and assisting them in navigating the healthcare and social sectors. Doula services have proven to be an effective strategy in addressing racial disparities in maternal health care by reducing severe maternal morbidity, and yet lack of awareness and access to doula services contribute to underserved communities. A study showed that overall, people who have continuous doula support services are 25%, shows a 25% decrease in cesareans and 8% decrease in spontaneous vaginal births, a 10% decrease in the use of any medication for pain relief and shorter labor by 41 minutes. A 2021 report by the New York City Department of Health found that doulas face barriers to providing services in hospital settings, such as requests to provide their training and or certifications. The presence of a doula can empower a pregnant person to make informed decisions and facilitate communication with their healthcare providers. They also provide support and peace of mind for caring for birthing persons. Over the past few years, my colleague in the Assembly and I have been advocating for doula services to be covered as a medical service. So today, as we're celebrating doulas, I ask my colleagues to continue to support us as we're asking for doula services to be covered and for doulas to be compensated the way they should be compensated for the medical services that they provide. Essential medical services, services that many people of many cultures look to outside of a hospital setting. So again, today it's Doula Recognition Day, and I ask you again, please support us as we are fighting to have doulas recognized for the important work that they do for those childbearing folks. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Prasad. Senator Brooke on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. And I also want to thank Senator Prasad for her leadership in introducing this resolution each year to recognize doula care, not just in New York, but as she stated, around the world. And it's hard to top that because it was so comprehensive. But simply put, doula care saves lives. You all have heard it before. Doula care saves mothers' lives and babies' lives. And I'm so proud of the work that this House has done to address the maternal mortality crisis, specifically as it relates to supporting doula care. As Senator Prasad said, doulas are especially skilled at interrupting harm that may take place towards a birthing parent during the birthing process. And they are essential in making sure that the voices of our birthing parents are heard and considered throughout that process. And as we sit here as legislators in the state of New York, where Black women are 5 times more likely to die in giving birth, and in a country where it is the most dangerous place in the developed world to give birth, we cannot afford to overlook the benefit that doulas and doula care can provide for our birthing people. That's why this House has hosted public hearings. That's why in this House's One House budget, we included an expansion of Medicaid to cover doula care at an equitable rate, as Senator Prasad pointed out. And that's why I'm proud to stand here and show my support for all of the work that we are doing in this House. And I want to end with the exciting moment we're in of having so many mothers and women, dare I say, probably the most this chamber has ever seen. And not only that, but people who have experienced doula care and who can speak on the importance of this type of care and be the voice for so many birthing people who do not have the privilege of sitting in our seats. So I hope that this legislature will continue to put forward these types of policies, putting mothers and their babies first. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Brooke. The resolution was previously adopted on January 18th. Senator Serrano.
Thank you, Mr. President. Let's please take up previously adopted resolution 543 by Senator Hinchey. Read the resolution, title only, and recognize Senator Hinchey on the resolution.
The Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 543 by Senator Hinchey, commending New York maple producers during the annual maple weekends on March 18th to 19th, 2023, and March 25th to 26th, 2023.
Senator Hinchey on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. The celebration of maple started as a single day, Maple Sunday, in 1995, and over the last 27 years has grown to expand 4 days over 2 weekends. This year, March 18th and 19th, and our upcoming weekend, March 25th and 26th. Maple is one of New York's fastest growing specialty crops, and we rank as the second largest maple producer in the country, only second to Vermont. We have the largest resource of tappable trees, and so we could be number one if we did some work to open up our state forest to maple tapping, something I know is important to the industry and also safe for our trees. We could be number one, but we will settle happily for number two. We have more than 2,000 maple sugar makers in New York, and some of these farms have been producing continually for over 200 years. As the New York State Maple Producer Association, Maple Producers Association says, this is agritourism at its best, these maple weekends. You can see how maple is collected, you can help tap a tree, you see sap collection, you see the boiling process, and of course, my favorite, everyone's favorite, you get to taste the products. There are some incredible events happening across our state this weekend, and I encourage all of our colleagues to check them out. There are a few across the 41st, Maple Leaf Sugaring in Ghent in Columbia County, New Beginnings Farmstead in Kingston, Platte Creek Maple Farm in Saugerties, and a host of others. I guarantee you, no matter where you live, there is one near you, and I encourage everyone to celebrate Maple Weekend and support our farmers and the farming communities that provide us with the delicious goods that we all love to enjoy. I'm really proud to celebrate Maple Weekend. Thank you to all of my colleagues.
Thank you, Senator Hinchey. Senator Borrello on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to join Senator Hinchey in welcoming everyone to Maple Weekend this coming weekend. You can go to mapleweekend.com to find out locations near you. I had the privilege last year of ceremonially tapping the first tree at Sprague's Maple Farm, where Randy Sprague handed me a tool that his grandfather actually used, and that was a lot of pressure to make sure I didn't screw it up, but thankfully I did not, and the tool survived my tree tapping. But this year, or last year, New York State produced a record 845,000 gallons of maple syrup. That's a record, and we hopefully will see more of that. We have innovative folks here. I met with them at their farms throughout New York State and even in my office here this session to talk about the innovation that they are doing, the new markets that they are looking for, things like maple bourbon and other things that are going to help expand the market and the uniqueness of New York's maple industry. So I'd like to have everyone join and celebrate the great maple industry here in New York State, number two in the nation, as Senator Hinchey mentioned, and hope that you all have a great opportunity to get out and celebrate Maple Weekend. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Borrello. The resolution was previously adopted on March 15th. Senator Serrano.
Thank you. At the request of the sponsors, the resolutions are open for co-sponsorship.
The resolutions are open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor on the resolutions, please notify the desk. Senator Serrano.
Thank you. Let's please take up the reading of the calendar.
Secretary Reed.
Calendar number 184, Senate Print 147A by Senator Giannaris, an act to amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act takes effect on the 90th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ortiz, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 184, voted in the negative, Senator Walzik, ayes 60, nays 1.
The bill's passed.
Calendar number 208, Senate Print 1054 by Senator Hinchey, an act to amend the agricultural markets law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ortiz, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill's passed.
Calendar number 463, Senate Print 151 by Senator Giannaris, an act to amend the criminal procedure law and the civil practice law and rules.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ortiz, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 463, those senators voted in a negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Felder, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Lanza, Martins, Matera, Murray, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rhodes, Rollison, Steck, Tedisco, Wozick, Weber, and White. Ayes 40, nays 21.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 47, Senate Print 4467A by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2.
The bill will be laid aside for the day.
Calendar number 48, Senate Print 4742 by Senator Cooney, an act to amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law.
Read the last section.
Section.
Lay the bill aside for the day.
Calendar number 493, Senate Print 5262 by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the Administrative Code of the City of New York.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 494, Senate Print 1296 by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the Elder Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 501, Senate Print 4516 by Senator Fernandez, an act to amend the General Obligations Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Dabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Fernandez to explain her vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. Targets of assault and discrimination are often required to sign NDAs, non-disclosure agreements, in order to receive compensation for the harm that they have experienced. These agreements frequently include language requiring victims to pay immense fines if they violate the agreement. This forces victims to choose between staying silent or pursuing justice at a huge financial cost. This bill prevents NDAs from including liquidated damages in cases of harassment and discrimination, so victims are not deterred from coming forward with their stories. No one should be intimidated or silenced, and this bill will protect them from coming forward if they're ever a victim of harassment or discrimination. Thank you. I vote in the affirmative.
Senator Fernandez to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 501, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Lanza, O'Mara, and Wozick. Ayes 58, nays 3.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 511, Senate Print 5186 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the Environmental Conservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 512, Senate Print 259 by Senator Serrano, an act to amend the Education Law and the Public Health Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Serrano to explain his vote.
Thank you. This bill will require cultural awareness and competence training for medical professionals. The communities that I represent in East Harlem and the South Bronx, and indeed many other communities throughout the state of New York, suffer from disproportionate health disparities, racial health disparities, continued health disparities when it comes to maternal health. And I believe that this additional training, this cultural competency training, will ensure that there's better lines of communications between medical professionals and the communities that they represent. And in turn, this will create better health outcomes, which will be great for the residents of New York and the entire state of New York. So I'm hopeful that my colleagues will support this legislation. Extremely important that we deal with and find different ways to address the health disparities in our community. Thank you.
Senator Serrano to be recorded in the Senator Serrano to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 512, those senators voted in a negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Lanza, Matera, Murray, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rhodes, Rollison, Steck, Tedisco, Wozick, Weber, and White. Also Senator Felder. Ayes 41, nays 20.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 513, Senate Print 1669 by Senator Addabbo, an act to amend the Education Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act takes effect on the 1st of July.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Aye, 61.
The bill is passed. Senator Serrano, that completes the reading of today's calendar.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
I move that we adjourn until Thursday, March 23rd at 11 a.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Thursday, March 23rd at 11 a.m.